Hey guys, this is Rahul and welcome to GoMahamaya.com, and in this tutorial we'll be learning how to protect your website from getting clickjacked in just 3 minutes. Before I start explaining how to fix clickjacking, first understand what is clickjacking. And on that screen you can see my mouse is moving. With that mouse, a follow Twitter icon is moving with me. And in real life, you will not see that Twitter follow icon is moving or any ads is moving on that. It's just a demonstration, that's why you are getting this views. Neither I can make copy of anything nor I can click. If I'll click, this Twitter button will get pop up. Let me show you. If I'll click on that, says you have to follow me or something like that, or you can get redirected the third party ads, which will be helpful for hackers in order to make money. So cancel this. And how to track what is the code behind that? Right click on that, and if you click on inspect, you'll find a iframe which says ID Twitter ID, something is moving on that, and you cannot find this page demonstrates simple clickjacking attack or something like that, right? You cannot find that unless until you make a click, that thing will get unactivated and admin of the page will never come to know that clickjacking is going on inside their page, because whenever they come to their website, they always say WP admin. They never click on their website in order to check pages or posts. And now we'll check whether our website is protected from clickjacking or not. You paste your website URL in this area. You'll find this link in the description box. And once you write your website URL, you click on test. And in this area, you'll find your score is C and your location and IP address. And now we'll go to our cPanel in order to fix this issue. And now once you are inside the cPanel, you have to scroll down and you have to find files. Click on files manager. And now here you'll find various sets of options. If you have only one domain, it will be inside public underscore HTML. If you have multiple domains like add-ons domain, it will be like outside your public underscore HTML, so which says your website name. My website is inside public underscore HTML, so I'll click on that. And once you are inside public underscore HTML, here you'll find .scss file. If you could not find .scss, you have to click on setting and you have to click on show hidden files. Click on save, and here you can find .scss. If you still could not find .scss, click on files, and here you have to type .scss in the file name. Make sure you're using dot in the beginning and click on create new one, as like I already have, so I'll click on OK. Now you have to select .scss and click edit and click on edit again. And now once you're on the scss page, you have to scroll down, and whatever the code is there inside the scss, you don't have to bother about that. Just reach in the last and give some enter. And here you have to paste the following codes, which is going to protect your website from getting clickjacked. And once you are done with the codes, you have to click on save changes. This code either you can take from my website or you can take from the description box. And now we'll go back to this website where you tested your website result. And there you need to either you write your URL here and click on test, or you can refresh it and click on continue. And now here you'll get a score. Bingo, no more clickjacking in a website. And if you want to protect your website from getting hacked, there's already tutorials I have created that is there inside the security playlist, so you can watch my complete playlist in order to make your website more secure. I hope you find this video useful. If you have any question or query, let me know in the comment section. If you haven't clicked subscribe, click on subscribe for the more further updates. Thank you.